Friends, we have been invited here today to share with Presh and Steve a very important moment in their lives. In the years they've been together, their love and understanding of each other has grown and matured, and now they decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, love has been your richest and greatest gift to the world. Love between two souls, which matures into marriage, is one of your most beautiful types of love. Today we celebrate that love. May your blessing be on this wedding service. We ask that you protect, guide, Precious, and Steve in their marriage. Surround them and us with your love now and always. Amen.
Amen.
Fresh and Steve, the covenant which you're about to make with each other is meant to be a beautiful and sacred expression of your love for each other. As you pledge your vows to each other and as you commit your lives to each other, we ask that you do so in all seriousness, and yet with a deep sense of joy and deep conviction that you're committing yourselves to a dynamic, growing relationship of trust, mutual support, and caring love. With that said, the most greatest part of this. Do you, Steve, take this woman, Presh, to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold in sickness and in health, in good times and bad, for richer or poorer, keeping yourself solely unto her for as long as you both shall live? If so, please answer with, I do.
I do.
Presh, do you take this man, Steve, to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold in sickness and in health, in good times and bad, for richer or poorer, keeping yourself solely unto him for as long as you both shall live? If so, please answer with, I do.
I do.
At this time, Presh and Steve have selected some promises they'd like to share with each other. I'm sorry. You first, Steve.
I, Steve, take you, Presh, to be my beloved wife, to have and to hold, to honor you, to treasure you, and to be by your side in sorrow and in joy, in the good times and in the bad, and to know, love, and cherish. To love and cherish you, always. I promise you this from my heart for all the days of my life. Excuse me. Nervous.
Okay. Okay. I, Presh, take you, Steve, to be my beloved... I can't do this. To be my beloved husband. To have and to hold, to honor you, to treasure you. Sorry. I'm sorry.
It's okay. This is your day.
To be at your side in sorrow and in joy, in the good times and in the bad. To love and cherish you always. I promise you from my heart and for all the days of my life. Sorry.
I'm sorry. This is your day.
My dog will be crying.
Dear Lord, we ask your blessing on these rings that Presh and Steve are about to exchange. Grant that the love which they feel for one another on this day reside always in their hearts. May these rings forever remind them of the vows which they have pledged to one another today, and may their compassion and kindness for each other always be as these rings, with no beginning and no end. Amen.
Amen.
Although you each wear one of them, these rings essentially belong to you both, for they are a symbol of the love you share and the promise that will be a strong and lasting love. Throughout the years, they will speak softly of your vow to grow along with one another, to face the challenges of life, to remain one another's first priority, and to keep your relationship rich and full. They will give you strength and comfort in times of uncertainty and heighten life's joys as you share them. Never again do you walk alone, for your love will be with you always. And now, as a token of your deep desire to be forever united in heart and soul, Steve, you may place a ring on the finger of your bride, and as you do, repeat to her after me these words. Presh.
Presh.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
Place it on all the way. And now, as a token of your love and as a deep desire to be forever united in heart and soul, Precious, you may place a ring on the finger of your husband, and as you do, repeat to him after me these words. Steve.
Steve.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
Place it on. Now, palms up. Okay, you're going to put one here. You're going to put under. There you go. Just like that. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day. As you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever, these are the hands that will work alongside yours as you build your future together. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch, comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow as well as tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children, the hands that will join your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it, and support and encouragement to pursue your dreams and comfort you through the difficult times. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Stephen Presh, your two hearts now beat as one. Your two souls now deeply joined anew. Walk forward forever, hand in hand. May your marriage be a lifelong celebration of love now that the rituals are complete and you've exchanged rings and made your promises. May your lives together be filled with love and laughter by the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel and the officiant of this truly, absolutely, truly joyous occasion. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Steve, you may kiss your beautiful bride. Thank you. Join with me as we ask God's blessing on this new couple. Eternal Father, Redeemer, we now turn to you as the first act of this couple in their newly formed union. We ask you to protect their home. May they always turn to you for guidance, for strength, for provision and direction. May they glorify you in the choices they make, in the ministries they involve themselves in, and in all they do. Use them to draw others to you, and let them stand as a testimony to the world of your faithfulness. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Family and friends, it is with great honor that I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Bernardino.
Shine, 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 shine. Searching for their towers.
Just to be with you. At this time, folks, we're going to ask all family members, guests, everyone, please join them on the dance floor. Come on.
This is true, but the good side of it is that it gives you energy. And that's what I see between both of you. It's lots of energy. Okay? So I want everyone to raise their toast to the bride and groom. Make all your ups and downs be under the covers. To see them precious.
Nice round of applause to David. Now we're going to turn the mic over to our maid of honor, Buddy. Come on up, Buddy.
Oh, man. I don't think I can drop that name. Oh, man, wow, this is real. So, no matter where you start, you're in the middle of it, right? So, Precious is kind of like a sister to me. We met when I was 15, freaking chemistry. We've been pretty much best friends ever since. And college and everything. And I remember kind of when you first kind of told me about Steve. The guy at the Radisson that was on the TV. And I was like, oh! And I got to meet kind of Steve for the first time. I don't remember too much of the details, but I do remember one. I do remember kind of, I don't know, you guys just had such a vibe, and I've never seen you laugh so much. And you know, that's how I could tell you guys really had something special. And it's like, there's kind of times in like life where you can tell that something's kind of an important moment. You just kind of like feel it in your heart. And I could tell when I like saw you guys together and I saw the vibes together. Like, I mean, it's, you know, only in hindsight you put it all together. But in the moment, I just kind of like, I felt that like this is going to be someone important. And it's been, gosh, like, I really feel like I got to see you guys grow together up close. And I used to kind of come down from Albany like once a month and stay with Precious and Steve like pretty much for like the weekend. David had a toothbrush for me that was dedicated to being special, just to kind of, but yeah, like, I mean, it's so amazing to watch you guys grow together and like, I can't believe it. So beautiful and look so dapper and gosh, like, I'm so happy for you guys. I'm very rarely at a loss for words for anybody who knows me, but this is definitely one of those times. Congratulations, and I love you guys.
Thank you, Bonnie. How about a nice round of applause again for Bonnie? child, guys. All right, and right now we're going to have our bride, Presh, come to the dance floor with her mom for a beautiful song by Brian Adams.
Leads on the most
to us. And that said, we have another exciting step in our lives at the end of this year. We're expecting to have.
I said, great, I have a niece, and I would like you to meet her. And that's how they met.
Oh, yeah.